Thanks for praying with us in chapel. I'm Father Ron Hoy with Shelby Monaghan and the team. This is the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 63, Thirsting. My soul thirsts for you, O God, as my dehydrated body craves water, but I can't see you.
I often lose touch with your loving kindness. My longing for you is the only real evidence I have that you are really here.
Still, I will seek you. Still, I will do your work. Still, I will remember you from my bed when I meditate before I sleep and when I wake in the night.
You have been my helper. I have taken refuge in the shadow of your wings. Dispatch my fears, O God. Help me find my center in you, and I will rejoice.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord said, "Go out and stand on the mountain in the presence of the Lord, for the Lord is about to pass by." Then a great and powerful wind tore the mountains apart and shattered the rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake came a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire came a gentle whisper. When Elijah heard it, he pulled his cloak over his face and went out and stood at the mouth of the cave. Then a voice said to him, "What are you doing here, Elijah?" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In the midst of global tumult, I am searching for rays of light, for pockets of peace, for God, as buried as God may feel right now. I search for that calm like a person searches for water in the desert, because I need to be sustained, and this is the only thing I know that can sustain me. I need those gulps of peace to soothe this pain. And in these moments, I look to Elijah. Commanded to look for God, he takes to the mountain and begins his watch. I invite you to come with me on a Lectio Divina style walk-through meditation on this reading. Elijah first had to scale the mountain. Think of the crunch of dirt and rocks under your feet, the warm sun on your face, the whipping up of the wind as you ascend higher and higher. The anticipation, the fear, the excitement. The Lord is passing by, and you will be present for it. Once at the top, the winds become near unbearable. Rocks fall and shatter. You can barely hear yourself think. Is this God? Is this the power and the might of the divine? Will I be blown off the mountain to my death? Then the winds calm. You have a moment to breathe before the earth begins to shake. You can feel it through your feet, up into even your teeth. The ground threatens to split open beneath you and swallow you whole. Is this God? Will I even survive this encounter? Then the ground stills. You wonder what you are doing here, if it's even wise to have come up here, when you smell it. Smoke, acrid and stinging in your nose. Moments later, you hear the flames and you see the light licking up brush on the mountain. Surely this is God, or surely it is the end of you. The heat feels strong. Then the flames die down. The ground around you is singed, plants blown over, rocks over the path that you took up the mountain. What am I doing here? Was any of that God? Was this a test? Am I just sacrificing my life for nothing? Is God just destruction and power? And then, in the quiet, a tug at your heart. A small, calm voice. The tone, kind and gentle. What are you doing here? In the midst of all of this, what are you doing? In the midst of all of our this, let us hear the calm voice of God asking us, what are we doing here? And let us contemplate that answer.
Believing the power of prayer, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, I want to live according to your word, your ways, your truth, rather than by what will make me popular and powerful. Give me the desire and the integrity to live every day like this. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thanks for being with us, folks. See you tomorrow.